Okay, now, got something new for you. Can you see this right here? I could tell something was really desperately wrong with my placement of the beachers. So I went in and I layered my painting over the photograph. And then I reduced the opacity and I traced the feature. Well, first I lined it up. I reduced it just a little bit so I could see through it and line it up. And I chose to line it up with the mouth. In which case you can see the nose is in a pretty good place. But the face is way too small and the eyes are way too high. The forehead, not in a bad place. I just have to lower these eyes and give her a little more jaw. So, this is what you call a sanity check. If I wanted it to look like her, I needed to do that. And often I wait too long to do it. So, you know, it's good to try to do it early on. And this is fairly early. I should have done it maybe a little bit sooner, but it's a really good tool if you have Photoshop, and I'm sure there's a lot of other programs you can use to do the same thing. So, I'm never married to anything. I could totally wipe out those eyes. It's no big deal at all. So, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move them down. So that they work better. Yeah. Get rid of these funny things. So I'll turn this a little bit this way. There we go. I wish I could figure out how to. Yeah. I'm new at this filming stuff. Sorry. Have you ever heard of Patreon? P-A-T-R-O-N, I think, P-A-T-R-E-O-N. And there is a woman on there that I follow, and I have learned so much from her. If you want to do it, it's just $5 a month. I don't even know why she charges so little, but she's so good. Her name is Miriam Hoffman, and I really think you would learn a lot from her. But let's do this, and I'll give you any instruction you want, but I just wanted to make you aware that you can get maybe someone who's better, has more equipment. She has all the equipment and everything. All the recording stuff that makes it better. She is really good. So, this eye, I'm gonna say it starts right under the bottom of that eye. And this one, because her head is slightly tilted, so this one is going to be just a wee bit lower. It's already looking more like her. Wow. That eyebrow, I mean, comes right above that, the old eye. See how easy that is? I've had to do this a million times because that's how I roll. I trial and error. But thank goodness for Photoshop. I tell you what. Okay, I'm just gonna kinda. Now the nose needs to be just a wee bit. Too much. The mouth. mouth just needs to be, the sides need to be a little bit lower. Well, this side's good. Okay. Now the sides of the face. Lord, I can't believe they're that. Side. She does have a very square jawline, but that just seems like a lot. Okay, I'm gonna go with it. Because your eyes, you just can't trust your eyes. Sometimes. Some people have like, what I call, like perfect pitch, only with their eyes. Not I. I struggle. Okay. God, that looks weird as hell right now. Okay, let's get back over to the let's see. Where's my eye thingy? There we are. Let's get over here. Get that worked in. Try to make it work. I mean, don't get me wrong when I say, you know, about Miriam Hoffman. She's amazing, but I love teaching. I just haven't done live teaching in a long time, and I don't have all the equipment for doing this type of teaching, but I want to learn. I want to get better at it. I'm sure she fixes things behind the scenes, but I wanted to do it in front of you. Because I wanted you to see that this is a good way to fix your mistakes. And your brain kind of knows when something's off, you know. It may not know what to do with it. It's like, excuse me, it's like you hear a song in your head, but you can't sing it. It's kind of the same thing. Sometimes you just need a little bit of help. This side just looks so huge. I'm gonna darken it a little bit. I feel like something's not right. Okay, we'll just go with it and think I've got enough now to go ahead and start the color. So I'm just going to use the same brushes that I used with the acrylic because I've washed them in water, rinsed them. Whole new palette going here. I'll put this down. Put the palette up here so I can show you. Okay. I did two bumps. Dumper. Listen, if you watch Miriam, she just puts little tiny dabs on there. She's so good at making her paint stretch. I'm not. And put a little cadmium. Oh, that's she's got a little bit of a warm skin tone. Here it is. Okay. These are probably close to all the colors we're going to need for this one. Okay. So I'm pretty picky about my palette knife. This one has a lot of bend in it. I bought so many, and they're just stiff as I'll get out. But you want one that's got some good motion to it. Okay. It's weird doing this vertically. Okay. So just mix it real good. By the way, if I didn't say, this is cadmium red medium. Take a little white. I think I need a little bit more orange in there. Be handy. Got me a little cadmium drip there. It's not quite enough. Okay, and these are for the more pinky tones. But you see how it really takes on a nice flesh tone there. It's really good for the warmer flesh tones. And if you ever do like African American skin or whatever, that's, you just add less white. It's a fantastic mix for African American. I actually got this recipe from Miriam Hoffman. I thought it worked a lot better than the one I have used for 20 years. Okay, here we go. So I put this in my palette. Put this back up here. Get my little tiny thing up the lick one. This one here is good too. It's green for oil. This one's wonderful. And it's a little expensive though, so I don't use it as much as I use the liquid one because it's pretty cheap. This is the liquid one. And a bottle like this is about $25, which is the same as what this costs, I think. So, I've got this on a subscription with Amazon. So I get a little bit of a discount. And I get a bottle of this like every 6 months. And I paint a lot. I paint every day. So it is needed. With a fairly wide brush. This is a 12. And I know it still doesn't look right, but we're going to work on it. So this side is drying, so I'm going to just kind of work on the neck right. You know, well, she has some glues in her neck, but we're just gonna let that gray show through. That'll give us those nice blues. edge right there, because I want that gray to come through a little bit. So I'm kind of thinning it right there. I don't want to mess with the shirt yet. I'm going to work on that last, because the flesh tones are the most important thing right now. So I think I can start on this side. I'm just going to use this big brush still and just lay in these darker tones. In the eyebrows. I do think lowering those eyes made a huge difference. And we'll see it more when we start to fill in the eyes. Happy Halloween, by the way. I'm still using this big brush, big-ish. It's not quite as big as the one I used on the background, but it keeps me from getting too detailed. I'll just keep going. I'm not gonna second guess myself. Not yet. Okay, now I'm gonna get into some smaller stuff, and I've got my zero. I said the chin is the hardest thing, especially if it's tilted, which ours is, ever so slightly. It's tilted, and sometimes they're tilted and you don't even know it. Something I think is really beautiful is this right here. That's where her shirt is reflecting on her face. That's pretty. And there's some really brighter highlights right here. probably go in the end and really brighten these really bright highlights there. On my palette, just for her eyes. And keep in mind, because this background is dark, I can go in at any time and reshape her cheeks, which I suspect I will be doing. Things. Sorry. I always forget to do that because if I don't, then they'll die on me or they will get so low that it's hard to get them fully charged. Okay. I'll turn this on the side so I don't mess up the face. I'm going to go in and kind of brighten the whole thing up a little bit. Do a little bit of blending. It's real easy to overblend, so be careful. If you overblend, you know, then you lose that nice painterly look. Which, that's, I really like the artist hand showing through. Whoops. So this one I'm trying to do just like a little bit more straightforward than the last one. The last one was more stylized. So I think that the face looks too big because it's pushed forward. I'm gonna do some, I think this chin, and like I said, chin's gonna be they are. They set the angle of the face. They give so much information. And all those little lights on her chin, they are vital to setting the angle. I suspect I'll probably bring her cheeks in about this far. Oh no, right now I need to leave it alone. Okay. Go back in with a smaller brush. To go back in and do those eyelids. Right now I'm just going to make them pink. She's got some frosty eyeshadow on. But I'm going to just make them look more natural right now. So now, the nose, if you'll notice, it's got some really nice information right here on the tips. Of the, what do you call those, phalanges or something. Some shading. And then a little bit lighter on the septum. And I'm very hesitantly going to in some color on the lips. Now for the darkest shadows on the lips, I am mixing my darkest flesh tone in some cadmium. So it will be almost brown. I can always brighten it up. Okay, now on this side. And go back in on this darkest one and kind of brighten it just a bit. Now I can pick up some highlights. And go back in to give it a little shape. It needs to be a little bit broader. Okay, I can live with that. Okay, let's start on the eyes. Of course, they're not like totally white. They're more like a little bit gray. Now, when I shop at Treacle, hope you can see this, I buy a lot of brushes. And yeah, it's like $200 every time I go in there. But when a brush gets a little raggedy, I can't use it. I don't know what it is, but I am not easy on my brushes. So I'm getting a new one. a new zero. And I might go in and get a new 20 zero in a minute, but let's do this right now. It's so nice to have new brushes. When they start getting a little bit low, I go shopping. That's the one thing I really do splurge on, is my brushes. I used to just buy a set of cheap brushes with every painting. But I don't know. It's just something different about having good brushes. Okay, now I gotta get the color for eyes. And I'm going to use Cerulean Blue Hue, and one of my favorite colors, Sap Green, which I need to buy more. My favorite green, Sap. It's just such a nice, rich color. Because her eyes are really blue, but they do have a slight amount of green in them. And I like to exaggerate. It's not quite blue enough. I almost put the pupil in first, but I decided to go with putting the color in first. I'm not sure I've made her irises big enough. Make them a little bit bigger. So my rule of thumb is you take someone's best feature and you exaggerate it. You make it a little bit bigger. I think I told you this before, and it just really makes it look more like them. Okay, now I'm gonna put that pupil in. So the eye is usually lighter at the bottom and darker at the top because you're casting a shadow of your, from the eyelid. And it gives it that three-dimensional look as well, especially when you also throw a shadow on the whites, which I'll do right here. So you see, even though I measured and everything, I didn't measure everything I needed to measure. I thought I had, but I didn't measure it properly. So, you know, going back and checking it with Photoshop is good. But when you're teaching it, you know, you're going to just kind of hope that you don't run into that. But just keeping it as simple as possible, as straightforward as you can, is going to make it easier. I'm going to go back in here and brighten it up a little bit. The nice thing about oil is it takes a while to dry. So you can go back in it, into it and work it. Just don't want to overwork it. Unfortunately, you can't hit an undo button. Whoops. I'm painting wet on wet, but I'm still putting in layers. And I'll come in after it dries and put in some more layers. Like I need to maybe do, I'm gonna do the Photoshop thing again. I still feel like those cheeks are off. Guess her chipmunk. She's a very thin girl, but just looks chipmunky to me. I don't know why my eyes can't really see what's wrong. you see it, you tell me. Okay, let me just do a little quick measure here. So from the corner of her mouth at 4 o'clock, it's that long, which is about an eye. Okay, eye at 4 o'clock. Okay. Sometimes it's just a little tiny amount. Seems to be right. Let me measure straight at 9 o'clock. Okay. Yeah, that's too big right there. Okay, let me, 3 o'clock. Pulled it in just a slight amount, and it seems to make a difference. What do you think? Oh, yeah. Much better. Okay. I'm going to put a little pink over here. Just a whisper. When I put in the next layer, I'll really brighten it up. But right now, these are the undertones. You know what? I really kind of got that right there wrong, didn't I? That highlight's going to be more over here.
Let's go pee-pee. I bet you need to go pee-pee.
go potty?
Mm-hmm.
Good girl.
Good girl. Come on. You want a treat? Peace. I'll get you a treat. Come on.
So much fun house training the puppy. Not. Best way to do hair is to do it in chunks. Just block it in at first. You can go back and do more later. Feel pretty good about the shape of her face. So I'll just use some of this brown that I used, this first mixture that I used for her darkest tones on her face for the hair. Yeah, it's probably not going to work for that part. I have to bring in a little yellow. Or maybe just... the orange. Her hair changes color every other week. Right now, it's pink and blue, or purple. Purple on the top and pink on the bottom. Rossiana, it's close enough. Mm-hmm. ask me why I just did that. I'm an idiot. Okay, here we go. So weird his hairdo. Some anime character that she always draws has this same hair, so she's, this is her thing, and it's just very different. To me, anyway. Maybe it's not. I'm gonna go ahead and kind of smooth some of that in. Weave it in. Put some bright highlights up here. Looking more like her. Yeah. But see how insecure you can get when it's not, when your brain, I mean, no matter how long you've painted, and even though you know it's going to happen, you just can't control it sometimes. The insecurity. But you just have to believe in yourself. So I'm going to go ahead and put a few little pops there. Her shiny little face. She's so cute. Too high. Pop a little highlights in there. What you doing? Thank you. 50. No, I don't want to do that one. What are you doing? Might be too early to be doing, but I'm doing it. She's got very shiny eyes. So I'm going ahead and throwing some red in these eyes just to give them some blood. layers tomorrow. Just do one more thing. I just don't want it to look overly blended. I can't stand that. A few little well-priced brush strokes. There we go. Boop. Maybe something right there. Okey-dokey. That is day one. See you tomorrow.